Hello, my friends. Welcome to Talk to Me Tuesday for Tuesday, February 9th, 2021. This is Jennifer. I don't have a big show and tell for you this week like I did last week, but I have a bunch of little stuff, so we'll just get started. I mentioned to you last week that I had bought a couple of Raggedy Andys to fix up. They came and I decided, because their hair was glued on, it was very matted and kind of gross, and so I wanted to remove their hair, and the easiest way to do that is just to soak it off. So my washing machine has a soak setting, so I put the two dolls in, put it on soak, thought I put it on soak, actually accidentally put it on hand wash, and one of the Andys came out fine. His hair came right off. It was moist and damp, and I peeled it right off. He's in really good shape. He's got like one little stain there that I haven't been able to get off, but otherwise he's in great shape, and he's definitely handmade. You can see like his little hand stitching and everything like that. He's got a couple pop seams, but otherwise he's in really good shape. The smaller doll, however, which I'm planning to make the sister companion to the Andy that I updated last year, he's a horror show. His hair did come off, but so did most of his head. I opened my washing machine, realized immediately what I had done, and was just sort of horrified. There was stuffing everywhere. I'm gonna try to hold his face together because it's awful when you don't. But his little head, it ripped in the back. I think what happened is the glue had kind of eaten through the fabric and it just yoinked his head off. And this little eye is loose, and his body is fine. So from the neck down, he's great. We're just gonna flip his head back so you don't have to look at that. So my plan is to get some matching fabric, and I'm gonna give this guy a head transplant. And when I'm done, this will be a Raggedy Ann to go with the Raggedy Andy that I repaired last year. I did finish and share my first Year of Doom 2021 quilt along for Fandom and Stitches. This is one of just a handful of patterns that I've designed for the year. This one is the Princess Bride, and it is the Man in Black. Amber tested this for me. This is my background fabric that I showed you guys previously. This is Grunge and Fig. The book titles are things I totally made up based on the movie. They're not in any way book titles. I did Count Rugen's Six-Fingered Handbook, Rotten Miracles, Adventures of the Dread Pirate Roberts, and A Kissing Book. And I've wanted to do the Man in Black's mask since we did the Princess Bride quilt along years ago, so I'm really glad I finally did that. I did make the skirt for my my ironing station. It's basically like two long table runners. This is the other side. I showed you guys that it was like an ombre fabric. So this is my ironing station. The skirt is literally just some yardage that I split and serged the edges of, and this is entirely to keep my fake best press that I make from getting all over the stuff that I'm storing on the cart. So I have to tell you about these serged edges. This was not done on my old serger. I bought a serger from a friend of mine, and this thread was on the serger when I took it out of the bag, and it is the perfect match. So I can't even imagine like how more meant to be. It's an ombre thread and it matches the fabric perfectly for the very first thing I wanted to serge. So how's that for kismet? Might have noticed this big box behind me. This is a box full of gorgeous crochet blankets that Prin sent for the Linus Connection. I am only gonna take a couple out because it's like a ton. This is like a whole video's worth of show and tell. But I did post these on my social media, and she posted them on hers. She is Chaos and Whimsy with an underscore at the end on Instagram. And you can just see how lovely this is. She is a professional crochet artist, and every year she makes and sends gorgeous crocheted blankets to Linus. She's also done quilts in the past, but she is nowhere near Texas, and I find it incredibly generous that she does this every single year. I think the only other thing I had to share was that I did organize my stash. I bought some little containers like this. This is a 15-quart Sterilite. I had one already, and then I think I purchased 7, which was all the store had, and, you know, that's fine. That actually worked out. And what I did was I took these upstairs, and I went shopping in my fabric stash. As I've mentioned before, my sewing room is being used as a guest room, so I don't have 100% access to all of my stuff. So I made a mini stash so I can work on my Year of Doom and whatever other project I want to work on this year without having to like go back and forth. I didn't actually leave that much fabric in there. My Star Trek row along is still in there because I haven't finished it yet. I have a row and a half plus the border to finish. So all of my batiks, I'm going to say 95% of my batiks are in there. I left a little bit of fabric in the dresser, but I had forgotten 2019, which was the last year that I was in my sewing room most. I think I was in there the whole year. I was in there until like November. Was the year that I just didn't buy fabric. That was my year of using what I had, and as a consequence, my fabric dresser was not very full, and that really surprised me. So most of what I had in my stash is now in here. This is my personal stash. We're not even going to talk about the Linus fabric I have because I have many bins of Linus fabric, but now I have what I need so that I can work on projects in the garage, and who knows, by the time I'm back in my sewing room, I'm guessing it'll be time to do some shopping again. Speaking of shopping, I did do a little bit. I ordered some fabric I needed for a project that's I'm not going to talk about quite yet. I bought that from Hip Stitch, and then I ordered some remnants from them because remnants. And then I also ordered from our very own Michelle's new company, Corner Curve Quilts, and I am going to have to put a picture here because I've already used some of it and I've already sorted the rest into my stash. So I bought some fat quarters from her because I was trying to build up my fabric for paper piecing this year, because it's been a while since I've done a big paper piecing project, and I wanted to build up my tone on tones. So that is going to be it for me. You guys have a very wonderful week. Have a crafty week. I hope you stay warm. I would love to see your projects if you're working on Fandom and Stitches, or if you're working on anything else. I would love to see your projects. And that's it. I will talk to you guys next week. Bye.